What's up, guys? Garrett here, and today I want to talk to those of you that are thinking of building your own home. I gotta be honest with you, if you are, I pity you and I applaud you at the same time. I spent 2 years building my own home from scratch, and that's with having an engineering degree as well as considerable remodeling experience with my own income properties as well as my previous properties. Building your own home is exhausting. It is time consuming, it is frustrating, and it is also one of the most rewarding things that you will ever do in your entire life. If you are thinking of doing it, I want you to answer these 6 questions before you ever actually break ground and start. The first thing I want you to think about is, do you have the skill necessary to build your own home? Are you mechanically inclined? Are you good with your hands? Do you know how to use basic tools and equipment? Do you know how to measure, mark, and cut all the lumber that you're going to need to do this accurately? Now, these are all learned skills, so you can learn on the job, but honestly, if you don't have any of these skills, you may want to reconsider whether you're going to build your own home. The second thing I want you to think about is, do you have the knowledge necessary to build your own home? Do you know how to read a basic set of plans? Do you know your local codes and regulations necessary to build in your jurisdiction? Do you know how to estimate materials off of those plans and then go to the store or your supplier and buy the correct materials as well as the correct amounts? Do you know the proper order in which to build your home? You know, even if you're gonna just subcontract the vast majority of this out, or you're gonna act as your own general contractor, you need to know that order, or else your timeline as well as your budget can get way out of whack. And you don't wanna do things twice just because you got the order wrong. Do you know how to problem solve on the fly? Trust me, a lot of problems are gonna arise, or just things that you didn't even think about, and you're gonna have to make quick snap decisions in order to keep the project on schedule. Number 3, do you have the budget that it's going to take to build your own home? It's going to cost a heck of a lot more than you think it does. So ask yourself, who made your budget? Did a contractor make your budget? Did the plan manufacturer make your budget? Did you make your budget? And if you are the one that made your budget and you've never budgeted one of these things before, honestly, double it, and that's probably what it's going to take. Within your budget, do you have a contingency line item? If you don't, add one. I would suggest at least 15 to 20% for the first time home builder. If you're fairly experienced, still at least 10% for contingency, just in case things do come up. Next, ask yourself, what happens if I run out of money? Where am I going to get more? Is the project just at a standstill? Do I have to get another loan? Will the bank give you more money? Do you have some savings back? These are all questions you really need to answer up front before you ever break ground. The 4th question to answer is whether or not you have the tools necessary to take on this kind of a project. Now, it takes a lot of tools and a lot of equipment to build a home. So if you're starting with absolutely nothing, you need to have a budget line item to buy some decent quality tools. Now, I'm not talking about Harbor Freight, but I'm also not saying that everything has to be DeWalt. Something in the middle of the road will do just fine. You're gonna need different kinds of saws, hammers, multiple tape measures. You're gonna break a bunch of them as you build. You're gonna need ladders, levels, nail guns, compressors, cords, generators, just a ton of different things to build your own home. You also need to think about the type of equipment that you're going to need. So you're probably going to need a telehandler to move equipment around as well as get things way up in the air. You're probably going to need a tractor to move dirt around or even material around. You're probably going to need a skid steer. You're probably going to need an excavator to dig your foundation or your footings. All of this equipment is extremely expensive, so if you're going to buy it yourself, plan to probably buy it used and then sell it at the end of the project. Otherwise, in your budget, you need to have a line item for rental equipment, and it needs to be pretty substantial. When I was building my home, I sure wish that I had the tools that I ended up with at the end in the very beginning. It would have saved probably a month or two of time. So when I started, I had just this really old crappy backhoe, and it more or less fell apart as the project went on. So I had to do a lot more renting of equipment. Eventually, I finally bought myself a pretty nice tractor. I got myself a mini excavator. I ended up spending about 10 grand in rental fees of just a telehandler. These were all things that I did not budget for up front, and they did definitely catch me off guard. The fifth question may be the most important question of all to answer, and that is, do you have the time to put into this project? Are you working a full-time job as you're doing this? Are you just taking a couple of months off to try to knock this project out? What is the timeline that you have for your project? Is it realistic? And to be honest, it's not. You're gonna add a lot of time to it. When I was building my home, I thought I could get the whole thing done in a year. And hindsight's always 20/20. It took me 2 years and 3 weeks to complete my project. Now, it's all gonna depend upon the size of your home. My home was 3,000 square feet on the main level plus another 3,000 square feet of basement. So it's a big home. Now, if you're building one smaller, it should take less time, but still, be reasonable and be realistic about how long it's actually going to take. And then ask yourself, what happens if I run out of time? What happens if I go past the deadline that I just gave myself? If you're working a full-time job, then you're probably gonna have to subcontract some more of that work out. But you should get a feel as you go along in your project where you are. You should set some kind of a schedule as you go and try to hit those milestones. Another factor you need to think about is fatigue. You are not going to have nearly as much energy as you think you are. You're gonna wear out pretty quick, although you will build some stamina as you go on, but still, you need to build that in your timeline. You're gonna have to take breaks. If you get too tired or too sick, take the break, don't feel bad about it, and then just move on. You can use that time to do some of the mental things, the thinking that you need to do, or maybe the material purchasing that you need to do. But don't be afraid to take breaks. Burnout is another problem that you're gonna come up against. Now again, in your schedule, make sure that you schedule some time just to rest, but there are gonna be some days where you just don't feel like doing anything. And on those days, my suggestion is to go there anyway, go to your job site, just pick something small, something that may only take, say, 15 to 30 minutes to do. Do that task and most likely you'll end up doing more tasks on top of it. But even if you don't do anything beyond that 15-minute task, you got something done that day. And remember, this is a marathon, not a sprint. You're basically doing 1,000 little projects that add up to one big home. So the main thing is just to put the time in. As long as you put the time in, even if it's little bits of time, it all adds up. And eventually, your house will be done, you'll be living in it, and you'll think back on it with extremely fond memories, even though it was grueling as you went. The last thing I want you to think about is, who's gonna be helping you with this project? Because you cannot do this alone. So is your spouse gonna be helping? Are your kids gonna be helping? Do you have friends or family that are gonna be helping? Honestly, when it comes to friends and family, outside of your immediate family, don't count on them. They'll make a lot of promises, but they generally won't come through. And don't hold that against them, because it's really a big ask to have them help you with your home project. You are very excited about this, but to them, it's just kind of a burden. My suggestion would be to subcontract any of the work that you're not confident doing. And then I would also probably hire one or two people that have some sort of experience building to help you. It's money well spent, and honestly, you just cannot do this on your own. Building your own home is one of the most challenging things that you'll ever tackle, assuming that you decide to tackle this project. It is hard. It is definitely not as hard, though, as crushing that like button down below. Come on, guys, smash it! Like I said before, building my own home was honestly one of the most rewarding things I ever did. Try to enjoy the process as you go through it. It's kind of a once-in-a-lifetime process, and it's a thing that you did yourself. It's something that you can say, yep, I built that myself, and no one can take that away from you. Also, take a lot of pictures. Try to get your kids involved in it. It's something that they will remember too forever. Thank you all for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, make sure you hit that subscription button down below. I'll see you next time.